as a beginner, there must be a simpler way to start generating SEO traffic without having to learn all this on-page code and build links. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down the easiest way to get more SEO traffic. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. As the SEO, eventually you will have to learn on-page SEO, and you'll also have to learn about link building. But when you're just starting off, the key that you need to remember is content is king. When you have content on your website, you're gonna get more traffic. When you don't have content on your website, you're gonna get less traffic. Google uses that content to put your website out there, so when people type in phrases around anything related to your website, your content has a higher probability of showing up. So if you're a beginner, the easiest way to generate traffic is to start writing content. But not any content. You have to actually write the right kind of content, and I'm going to show you how to do that. First off, I want you to go to neilpatel.com/ubersuggest, and I want you to type in a keyword related to the content you want to write. If you don't know what keyword related to the content that you want to write, just put in a keyword related to your industry. For example, I am in the digital marketing industry. So I just may type in digital marketing or marketing, and Ubersuggest will load an overview. The overview will show me how many people are typing in that keyword within my region being the United States, on a monthly basis. I can see roughly how popular that keyword is. And then I can scroll all the way down to the content ideas. And then I can click view all content ideas. This will show me all the blog post ideas related to the term digital marketing that people are writing on. And as you can see here, some of them aren't that great or relevant. Some of them are good. And you just scroll down until you find something that you're like, all right, I would write on this. 6 tips for making the most out of digital marketing time. Nope. Let's see, digital marketing training, nope. Free web design, a guide to the next 10 jobs, nope. Silent tips, not really interested in writing about photography related to digital marketing. 30 overused buzzwords in digital marketing. Sorry, digital marketing, let's see. Top 500 social media digital, no. Ultimate guide to digital marketing, a hands-on primer. I like this. Not bad. I can actually create something similar. So then you click the keywords dropdown, and you'll start seeing keywords. Digital marketing guides, guide to digital marketing, online marketing guides. So this is giving me some keyword ideas on some keywords that I can use. What I want you to do is go to the keyword ideas report now in the left-hand navigation, and you see the term digital marketing that I just typed in. And if that's one of the phrases, cool. What you'll want to do is you'll want to select it, and then you want to click add to list. And you probably don't have anything here, so you'll want to label your list, and then I'll click a new label. So let's do digital marketing blog post. All right, I got a label, add keyword. And this will also give me other terms related to digital marketing. Digital marketing companies probably use a lot. What is digital marketing? Already added digital marketing. Let's see, digital marketing strategy. I should probably talk about that. I should probably even break down the definition. I should, let's see, talk about how to find freelancers to help you out. Maybe I can even talk about how to find agencies. Where is agency? I can probably talk about that. Let's see, tools. I think that's important. People probably want to know about tools. Marketing Google, how it's related to Google, digital marketing Google. How to create a blog, right? Digital marketing blogs. And let me add these to the list. So now that we added some of those keywords, I also want to type in other keywords, like online marketing was another good keyword that the article ranked for that we saw. So let's see, online marketing, courses, degrees, online marketing degrees. Let's talk about strategies related to online marketing. Let's talk about online marketing tools. Let's talk about online marketing videos. Let's talk about learning online marketing or how to start an online marketing. And then I can just keep going, and I would keep going down and down and down, and then I'll go to the next page and keep doing this. And as you do this, you want to add those keywords to the list. So I would add it to my digital marketing blog post list because that's a blog post I'm writing on. And as you can see here, if I go to keyword list and then I click on digital marketing blog post and I can keep adding more to it, I now have a list of keywords that can potentially could be included in the blog post that I'm writing on when it comes to digital marketing or a guide to digital marketing, how to learn it. And I can include all these terms in there. So the key to writing content is you need to include popular keywords. If you don't, then you're not really gonna rank for anything that can drive traffic to your website. Now, granted, you won't automatically rank for all these keywords, but you will rank for a portion of them. And the more you include, the higher probability that you'll have to rank for at least some of them. And if you're including keywords that are related to your content and you go top down, what I mean by top down, we'll go back to the keyword ideas report. When you're selecting keywords towards the top and then you keep going down, the ones at the top tend to be more popular. When you also select ones that have a low SEO difficulty score that are in green, those are ones that are easier to rank for. So if you select popular keywords that are easy to rank for, you have a higher probability of ranking for those terms. And as you write content and publish it on your website, you have a high probability of getting more SEO traffic. Now, if you do this for every blog post that you want to write and you just keep track of your keyword ideas list, you'll be better off. And the key here is to create a list for every blog post that you're trying to create and don't keep including the same keywords over and over again. What I mean by that is you don't want to have 10 posts related to online marketing tools. So you want to keep using new keywords per post. Sure, there'll be some overlap here and there, but you shouldn't be overlapping 100% of your keywords per post. Maybe you're overlapping on 5% or a small percent, and that's fine, but the majority of the keywords per post should be new, so you wanna do this exercise each and every time you write a blog post, so that way you're targeting new keywords that'll help you generate traffic. That's all you have to do to start getting more traffic when you're creating content, especially if you're looking for SEO traffic. If you enjoyed this video, like it, share it, tell the people about it. Make sure you subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and I'll answer it. Or if you just want my team to do this all for you, check out my ad agency, NP Digital, or Neil Patel Digital for long. Thank you very much for your time.